Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to be doing a remake of God is a Dancer by Tiësto and Mabel, which brings us back to like 2019, 2020 I think. It's an absolute banger, it was one of my favourite songs at the time. Let's jump into the verses and see how close we can get. We're going to jump straight into the main sound on this song, which is a marimba-y pluck sound, but I've actually used a preset here called Plucky from Main Stage Volume 1, and I've kind of changed the shape around a bit more to match the original. And so here I've created the top line MIDI for it, which is playing the exact same preset, and this is how they both sound together with the vocal. God is a dancer, yeah, I heard on the radio that she always go harder, cause she keeping you on your toes, and she's perfectly focused, she's lost in the moment, So we're going to take a quick look at the processing, where we start with some kickstart, and we're using the classic chain on 15% mix, which is so subtle, but I feel like there's a little bit of that suction effect going on with the whole pluck at the start here. And then I've automated this mix amount later on in the song where you've got some different parts like the drop, for example. And then we've got the delay, which comes actually after the kickstart. And I wanted this delay sound to not be ducked by the whole side chain. So I put it after there in the signal chain. And this is how it sounds, just doing a ping pong delay. God is a dancer. Yeah, I heard on the radio that she always go- Next up, we've got this simple re-space, which I've taken from Car Music Volume 4. And this just felt like the perfect preset to recreate the original. So if I play you that with the chords. Are you feeling that fire? Cause the music is on the way. If you wanna be higher, wanna move till the break of day. Why? Better go, better watch it. Why? 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 Just take a step. So it's quite a simple verse, but what we have here is a little part that swells into the next section. So I've taken this sweep from Car Music Volume 4. Why? Why? And there's a really subtle organ pad sound which opens up just before this part, and it's used later on in the production as well. This is the preset I've used, it's called Digi Organ. You can get it from Main Stage Volume 1, which I'll be linking down below so you can grab that for yourselves. And essentially what I've changed here is the attack time, so it kind of swells into it a bit more. And these are the chords we've got, so they're quite different to the rest of the song, but this is what I had to make to kind of get closest to it. So here we're heading into this pre-chorus section, which is a bit like a chorus itself because it's got a kick and bass, which is kind of atypical of a normal house song, I guess. You would normally just go straight into a drop, but here we've got this section. So this is the kick I've used for it. It's from Car Music Volume 2. Step by step when you come. We've got this clap here from Car Music Volume 4, which is a bit of a smackier kind of clap. Step by step when you come out on the... So I noticed there's actually no pre-shift on these claps. It's all kind of on the grid, but it sounds really good, so I can't really say anything about it. Step by step when... So here we introduce the first bassline sound, and this is a preset called FM from Car Music Volume 4, a really good sound, and this is the MIDI that we've got for it. I'm then going to beef up this sound with this preset called Often. This is such a versatile sound, you can use it like on any kind of track, it's sick. And then we've got this ultra deep sound which is called Going. Super deep vibes, and you can just again layer that and it will just add a lot more depth to your whole sound and just make it feel really heavy in the low end. We're then going to wrap up this whole bassline sound with this one shot here. And this is how it sounds all together. So this is what we have for the pre-chorus part. Step by step, when you come out on the floor, you got the left, right, left to leave. I'm coming back for more, you got the step. If we go and check the processing for this bass, it's really simple. We've got some reverb. I feel like the reverb and wet amount was really heavy on this bass, but there's not like a lot of decay necessarily, so that's kind of what I've tried to replicate here. And then we've got some kickstart using the classic chain again, but then it's mixed at 20%, so it's kind of a light side chain until we hit the chorus part. So now again, I've duplicated this part here and the pad's kind of been stretched out for double the amount of time, and you'll hear it again emulates the swell that we've got going into this next part before the actual main chorus. All right, so let's go and take a listen to the whole verse and pre-chorus slash build section. I don't really know how you'd call the arrangement on this song. It's quite unique, but if you enjoyed the video, make sure you smash the like button, hit subscribe so you don't miss Friday's video where we'll go and make the entire drop. But thank you for watching and let's take a listen. She's perfect.